Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Michael Wilson, your host of Midnight Judgment. Tonight I'm coming to you with something special. A little different this time. This is the CAD party of Midnight Judgment. In other words, we'll still show footage, bloopers, we'll show footage of the old, some of the old Midnight Judgment scenes. Some of the Midnight Judgment cast, we'll have interviews tonight. We're going to do a lot of great things, ladies and gentlemen, within this next 28 minutes. So come with us and enjoy this and celebrate with us for being 6 years on the air. It's been 6 years. Yes, 1998 we started Midnight Judgment. And also to give you an update, we got new episodes. I'm sure you have seen down below at midnight, or you have seen Midnight Redemption. And we got another episode coming up called Night of the Old Man, and other great episodes coming up in the future. But someone may say, when are you going to stop this Midnight Judgment? When? No, it'll never end. As long as it's free television, as long as public access has free television, and as long as I have breath in my body, Midnight Judgment, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Back. This is Mike Wilson, your host of Midnight Judgment. And I have with me here Bobby Bohannon. I'm sure you know him by now. He was in Mr. D. He played Jack Diamond. Also, he played Willie Johnson in our new episode we did called Midnight Redemption. Also, he was in Down Below at Midnight where he played the devil.
Come on now. You said you want to be on TV, right? What's her name?
Akilah.
This is little Akilah. Akilah Jean. Glenn. I'm sorry, artist. Glenn. Okay. Anyway, she was at midnight. And she was in the hell scene at the end, where the fall came up and everything. I'm sure other people, who all else was in that scene?
She's his granddaughter.
Okay. Now, by the way, artist, this is his granddaughter. She came along and helped me out real fine and well. You got anything you want to say to the audience out there, young lady? How did you like doing that episode? For training? Mama, you love, so we see.
No, but I just
look
like.
So we got a good future for you then. So you may have a seat. Go ahead. What would you, before been on the air for 6 years, how did you like working with this episode? You like the character? What would your.
Well, Mike, I think the character was Jack Diamond.
You fit the
really point. Deep, you know?
Yeah, Jack Diamond.
It gave me a chance to explore and be in different characters and just work on it better than what I have today.
How do you like filmmaking?
I like that ice cream.
Movie making is nice, man.
Okay.
It's really nice.
Okay.
I really enjoy it.
You'll never know.
That's what I'm telling you.
You might be just. By the way, Midnight Judgment is seen all over Fairfield, Ohio, and seen all over Cincinnati. And people, tell me this, man, when people stop you, you brought my kids around your house and all that. Tell me that experience.
Well, I tell you, my experience with kids coming up to me, telling me they see me in movies, and they want to play in the movie with me. I mean, it made me feel like I'm just that boss.
It made you feel big, proud? People stop you on the street. You're like, on my job, where I work at, people have stopped me.
See what I'm saying? Much for being a star.
See what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know something? You can be a star right here.
Right here.
We ain't got to go to Hollywood right now.
Go to Hollywood right now.
Yeah, but a star right here, because you are seen all over, like I said, Fairfield, Ohio, all over the city. So, ladies and gentlemen, right now we're going to take a little commercial break, and we're going to show you one of our bloopers. This will be when you and Brother Huck will be in the what we're going to show tonight here. When y'all are fighting with the gun.
Yeah.
Yeah, and when he said cut.
Yeah.
So we're going to show that.
She's not even nowhere around.
I told you it was your responsibility. What I tell you?
Come on, Willie.
I told you.
me to kill you. Hey, Willie.
I told you.
They killed you. Remember what the guy said about the rap swindlers in jail? Remember that? Remember that, Willie? Calm down. Willie, don't point the gun at me. Willie?
Hey, you gotta take this all over. This is all of me.
But you see, Brother Huckabee's head cut.
Yeah, he said cut.
Wasn't there something?
Pow, something.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we got a lot of things in store for you tonight. You're going to get a chance to talk about other characters that was in Midnight Judgment. They might say, why you're not doing drama at this part of Midnight Judgment? Believe me, I got a surprise for you at the end. At the end of this program, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to see. You know I can't go without doing no little drama scene. You know me, it's in my blood. You're talking about this. I've been doing this for almost 30 years. And also, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to do a two-part documentary on my life. It'll be called A Whirlwind Encounter. And you'll hear more about my life, how I got started in drugs, how I saw the tornado in 1974, and how God helps me. The drama, the TV drama.
And we have Brother Richard Huckabee. He was in the episode, Mr. D. Matter of fact, he was in most of my episodes.
6 long years he's been with me. And he didn't say his experience that he had in these 6 years.
Mike, the last 4, 5, 6 years, it's been a blessing. It's been an outlet to express, because we're doing all of this for the kingdom building of God. This is God's work, and this is fun work for God. In the name of Jesus, this has been glorified. It's been great. It's all to the glory of God. And it's been a pleasure doing this. And if any of you get a chance to experience this joy and partake, contact Brother Mike Wilson, and he'll put you in one.
So thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This time we're going to get a little footage of my guests.
Look, I had to let myself in. That's just not nice.
Oh, there's Sister Fogle. Praise the Lord, Sister Fogle. Yeah, I bet you.
A star.
Oh, yeah. And this is the folk. This is Sister Fogle. She may want to tell us about herself, the experience she had with Midnight Judgment. She was in, matter of fact, she's on one now here.
On one now.
Yeah, she's
see?
On. Yeah,
on one
she's,
now.
The name of this one is 7 Days Till Midnight.
Oh, 7 Days.
And she was also in the Midnight Strange. So, Sister Fogle, you want to tell us your experience in Midnight Judgment at the
Midnight
time?
Just wonderful. I tell you what, reached a lot of people, a lot of my friends that here that they saw it. Grocery store. Brother Mike is just great with his imagination, his Rod Sterling self.
Yeah.
We love him to death, and we think it's just great. I love Midnight Jump, and I'm ready to do some more. What
yeah.
are you writing? What
we are ready doing? For it.
But right now, you know, I just want you ready for the camera. Somebody.
Enjoy yourself, everybody.
Everybody.
There's my cast members there getting ready to dine and eat right now, ladies and gentlemen. And why don't we take a break and we'll be back. We're going to...
When he says
right.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mike Wilson, your host of Midnight Judgment, and we're still continuing the party. And we have our guest, we have our guest here among us tonight. You want to tell your name? Yeah, tell me your name, please.
Phyllis Shaw.
And Chia being our next episode, Phyllis Shaw being our next episode entitled Night of the Old Man. And she and she's also, I believe, you have watched Midnight Judgment in your home, so she's a viewer of one of my audiences of this show. Ladies and gentlemen, you may wonder what we are doing Midnight Judgment. As I told you in the beginning, it's for you, the community. If they don't right here, right at home. But you know what? In a clean, it can be clean Hollywood. You know, you need some all out there in Hollywood. But think about what we are trying to tell you. Take a look at it visually, ladies and gentlemen. I was trying to tell you the message in it. The message is so dynamite in it as you go through it. Like, you know, the episode we in the streets, and you know it's death out there. So, ladies and gentlemen, our program, the purpose of our program, even though I'm here to entertain you, I'm going to entertain you, but that's not the main purpose. I ain't going to tell you I'm not going to entertain you. I am. Because, see, the purpose of filmmaking is to entertain, self-revelation, and to enlighten. 3 main purposes or movie maker. That's the three main purposes of it. But that's not my main purpose, is to entertain you. My main purpose is to lead you to God. I'm telling the story to you visually. Now we're gonna one of our bloopers. We're gonna get right back with you, so stay tuned and we'll be right back.
Yo, JD. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, this JD right here, man. That's who you've been looking for. I'm saying it's the clown I was telling you about right there. Yeah.
Yeah. Turn my ear, my man.
So you're JD.
Got that right.
Well, I'm the man of the streets now. And you have until midnight to get out of Dodge or face me.
Who is that? Midnight. Get out of town.
You have until midnight to get out of town or you'll have an appointment with me.
I'd rather face you.
Your days are numbered. Now your day.
Stay right there.
Until midnight, get out of Dodge or your days are numbered.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for looking at that loop of that commercial you did. Thanks for joining us again once again with the Midnight Judgment Cast Party. Like I said, remember, stay tuned for the end. This is not just a cast party, I got a surprise for you. But who I have here now, Mr. Larry Pendleton. He was part of one of our newest episodes entitled Down Below at Midnight, dealing with the subject of hell. And right now I want to ask him, what was your experience with that? How did you fit in? Matter of fact, he was new at it too. He had someone else for it. He came at the last minute. So how did you feel with that? Tell the audience that, Mr. Larry.
Well, it was a nice experience for me. You know, it was something I pretty much wanted to get into. And basically, history, I was pretty much hungry for it. And you know, I see Brother Mike Wilson, who I've known for quite some time since I was a little kid. You know, he was real excited about it, and you know, it was an honor that he allowed me to part. And you know, I just tried to carry it the best way I possibly could, and I had a great time doing it. You know, I was very excited, just waiting for it to debut and everything. And when it did, I heard a lot of good things about it, so I was glad to work with Brother Mike, and I'm forward to our next project.
Man, our next project will be that he's gonna work with me on. I'm sure a lot of you have saw warning signs dealing with the biblical, the end time, the book of Revelation. I'm gonna make a, stay tuned, you'll be hearing more out there. I'm gonna make a sequel to Warning Signs. So take tune, and he's gonna help me, he's gonna co-produce it with me, Mr. Larry Pendleton. And this time we're gonna show you another blooper, another commercial, and we'll be right back with you with more.
Yeah, yes I am, this is fine.
So you one of those-
For years, this is me. I mean, he even went by all kinds of characters. I really appreciate Brother Uncle B for working with me. He's my big man. God, with the back.
What the hell?
That's it. That was too crazy. We should think about going to that oneness church with Ronnie. I'm
sorry. Then, to verbally and with their physically try to get the whole team to guess the word. It's going to be from the sub. So, and part of the other team, and then so forth. And then once the buzzer beeps, whoever's left with the catchphrase machine is the loser, and the other team gets a point. And the first one to 7 wins.
Okay. Very good. Okay, so how many people is going to play? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. You're going to have to play, Alexis, to make it 8 even, okay? 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay.
Yeah, this is your host, Michael Wilson.
Catchphrase.
We playing a game.
And then the next person in your team. The next.
Right now, we're going to get ready in a few minutes, but I'm going to tell you some few more things as we wind down. Remember, and also I'd like you to meet, can you stand up? He was Carl Smith and his very dear wife. You want to stand for Harling and T. Harling is here to see you. She's one of, they did a great job in.
She didn't get on.
In
my wife.
Come on, come on in. Come on in.
And the baby.
Yeah, get the baby in here. This is Carl Smith and his wife, Valerie Smith. They was in behind the door. Didn't y'all have anything to say to the audience?
No.
Anybody you have anything to say to the audience? TV on? You want to see? This is Larry Pendleton's wife. Right, and she was in down below at Midtown. She helped me direct them. And we thank God for our other guests here tonight. And like I said, we got other episodes. So it'll be Night of the Old Man. And by the way, all if I haven't told you, you remember when that 74 toilet, when I seen that, all that 19 from the street in my life, ladies and gentlemen. And you want to show you that surprise at the end. You will see it for that. This is no fun side of us. Okay, everybody, you freeze. You need a signal for them to freeze to me. I'm on pause first, right?
Yes.
And then get everybody pause first before they freeze, right?
They freeze and I put it on.
Come on, we can get
this is
okay. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
God bless you.
Happy birthday to you.
Wait. This is a great party now.
Happy birthday to you.
What is going on here?
Where did everybody go? Everybody, I thought we had a party going on.
What's going on here, TV on? What's up in there? What's up with this?
Where do people go?
I did everything. I'm trying to make it.
Oh, no.
I'm trying to feed them.
Going with it.
Somebody playing games. Y'all playing games with me.
I can't believe it.
Y'all playing it's too much. Y'all playing games with me. Clock strike me.
This independently produced program was scheduled for cablecast through Waycross Community Media, the Access Partnership of Forest Park, Green Hills, and Springfield Township. Opinions expressed are those of the producer and do not necessarily represent the Community Programming Board, volunteers and staff, Cross Media Center, the community governments, or the cable company. If you have questions or comments about community access, or if you would like to participate in the activities of Waycross, call 825-2429. Or write Waycross Community Media, 208 Waycross Road, Forest Park, Ohio, 45240.